Let's get it. Hop off a 16 passenger. This a G5. No, this not a Challenger. Big one. I keep some members with me in the fridge. The coat seats, they some cannibals. Eaters. They like to geek. Drink a whole bottle, wake up and repeat. Damn. She took a look, mixed it with the chill out. Now she say she's saying 3D. Wow. I go in the jungle and they got a coat. I bet I come out with a meme. I bet I do this shit for the fam. Cause this shit bigger than me. Big. Color stones in my infinity lane. And in the factory masterpiece. Factory. I call him twin, could that be my brother? We got the same roller, he matching me. Nah, for real.
Water on me, like the sun of song. Carrots, some pointers. Woo. All these comers, I want fun. From me go gunners out the jungle. Buy it all, fuck a frontal. Fuck nigga, cake on me, no funnel. Cash, drop top, feeling like stunner. Drop top, KD play, no runner. We gon' chrome my wallet, woo, smoke my pilot. Woo. Take the revive to the trappers.
Trappy,
nigga, one shit. I was outside just serving narcotics. Pay me that stick, nigga made one wrong move, jet popping. Living on broke with the whole flooded out in the hotel lobby. It's crowded. Diamonds be dancing like Bobby.
They dance.
Don't touch a dick like if you cocky.
Don't touch it.
Shroom and G's at the party.
We get you.
Bitches gon' trend on the top.
Keep trending.
The way I pull up, I'ma pop it and none of these niggas gon' stop me.
Pull up.
Gone. Put this shit on, get a cup for the drip. I'm a motherfucking fast.
Keep low.
Keep stacking your bank, I'll get bigger.
Go.
Never would I throw some shit on no nigga.
On tape.
Little nigga, don't blow with these niggas.
No.
I see the big picture, we up on these niggas.
Oh.
The huncho, the one you gon' call on me, nigga.
Joke.
I got your back, you gon' follow me, nigga.
Ball.
When I get up, we gon' ball on these niggas.
Ball.
Fucking shit up, cause we beat out the system.
Fuck the system.
Water on me, like the sun of song. Carrots, some pointers.
Woo.
All these comers, I want fun.
Fun.
Me go gunners out the jungle. Buy it all, fuck a frontal.
Fuck, nigga.
Cake on me, no funnel.
Cash.
Drop top, feeling like stunner.
Drop top.
KD play, no runner.
We gon'
chrome my wallet, smoke my pilot. Take the revive to the trappers.
Go.
Nigga, one shit. I was outside just serving narcotics.
Narcotics.
Woo. Pay me that stick. Nigga made one wrong move, jet popping.
Popping.
Living on broke with the whole flooded out in the hotel lobby.
Flooded.
California,
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 California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California, California
try. Coast. Here in Little John Coliseum, Chase Hunter and the Clemson Tigers want to begin the Thanksgiving celebration early, taking on Loyola of Maryland out of the Patriot League. Hi, everybody, and welcome in with J.D. Powell, Pete Yannity, a Tiger team that's trying to extend a winning streak and trying to remain engaged as they head into the holidays.
Sure. Coach Brownell and the Tigers have played much better in the last two games. The schedule's about to get harder as we head to Thanksgiving. They want to keep that up.
Now, Loyola, a team that has some experience, one of them, Kenneth Jones, a fifth-year senior. He decided to come back. His role has changed this year compared to last.
Kenny Jones is an outstanding playmaker. He led the Patriot League in assists per game last year. He's off to a great start scoring the basketball for the Greyhounds this year.
Now, like last season, especially late, Chase Hunter's been scoring for Clemson, but he also has added something to his game this year.
Chase is shooting the ball outstanding from three at over 70% right now, while still distributing and creating for his teammates. He's off to an outstanding start.
Tigers are 12-0 all-time against Patriot League teams. First meeting against Loyola, located a little bit north of downtown Baltimore. A few years ago, Colgate, which has become a perennial power in that conference, came in here and gave Clemson a 40-minute ball game before the Tigers prevailed against the Red Raiders. And they're going to see a team that plays a lot of Princeton offense, and they'll really need to be capable of defending that tonight.
Yeah, it was great visiting with associate head coach Billy Dolan before the game. We talked about that exact point. And the Tigers in November have had to guard a lot of different offensive actions. This one tonight is another great challenge. Coach Brennell talked about being disciplined against Brown against Bellarmine on Friday. They'll have to be disciplined again tonight as well.
Jalen Andrews, the other fifth-year senior who decided to return for the Greyhounds. A year ago, they were 14-16, 8-10 in the Patriots. They did return 13 players, three fifth-year players, and then added a couple of others. So they've got a deep bench. Brevin Galloway was in the wrong place, and he sheepishly grins before Doug Sermons tosses it up to get things going. The Tigers have the ball first, trying to improve to 4-1 on the season and go 4-0 at home here in Littlejohn.
So the Greyhounds want to get out and be active in the passing lanes. They want to pressure. But as we've seen the Tigers do all year so far, they want to throw it inside to their guards.
Posting up the 6'3 Hunter for the first bucket of the game. Loyola, they go about 8 or 9 deep. Fellow with the ball is a freshman who's come in and helped them. Isaiah Alexander joining those fifth-year seniors, Jones and Andrews. And Golden DK, an intriguing player, takes the feed, the finish, and he'll head to the line as Middlebrooks picks up his first foul.
So Loyola, like so many teams in college basketball, they've got some really experienced guys. They've got some younger guys as well. Those older guys are leading the way right now. But you see right there on that first possession, Deion Perry, a freshman out of Baltimore, creating for DK, rolling to the rim. They get great movement. Perry is an outstanding passer.
DK now 1-for-4 on the season on free throws. Didn't play in a victory against a D3 team the other day for load management reasons as the Tigers starting five. Not only includes Hunter and Brevin Galloway, Alex Hemingway doing some good work. Hunter Tyson and Ben Middlebrooks, but we will see others soon. Middlebrooks working inside on DK. And the sophomore unable to get the offensive rebound. So the guy with the ball, you mentioned him, Deion Perry, freshman from the Baltimore area. 29 points a game a year ago. Best point guard in Baltimore last year in the high school ranks, says his head coach, but at 5'8", the major teams overlooked him. Bad miss there. Tigers will take it the other way. Galloway off a good effort against Bellarmine the other night. Changing hands. JD, give us your keys to the game.
I think the big thing for Loyola is going to be defensive rebounding and finishing the possession. For the Tigers, it's all about limiting turnovers. They've been really efficient offensively when they've taken care of the basketball.
Nice denial that time. Middlebrooks knocked it away. Hunter by himself. Tyson. Good follow. Hunter missed it. Hunter scored it. And the Tigers build the lead to 4.
Right there to tip it in and on cue. Tigers are able to get an extra possession with that offensive rebound by Hunter Tyson.
Loyola, 37% three-point shooting team. DK, the dump, whistle inside, offensive foul. Good job by Tyson to hold his ground.
Hunter Tyson makes so many plays that don't show up in a stat sheet like that charge right there. DK catches it, he's coming downhill. That's a big guy who is pretty skilled and can pass it. But Hunter Tyson knows that he can't come to a stop. He steps in there, takes that charge, and it leads to a turnover.
Hunter Tyson given a moment by our veteran officiating crew to catch his breath. Took a hard shot there. Jamie Lucky, Doug Sermons, Kip Kissinger, our refs tonight.
Outstanding veteran crew with us tonight in Clemson.
Tyson for P.J. Hall, who just checked in. Hunter, and taken away. Perry, the freshman. Doesn't have numbers, pulls up instead. Deion Perry, 41% from downtown. He averages 8 a game. We told you he was a prolific scorer as a high schooler.
He's coming off of an outstanding game against Washington College last week. I think his confidence is going to be improved from that.
From out front, Tyson.
Hunter's able to get his feet set right there. They move the ball side to side off that high post screen.
Loyola team that took DePaul down to the wire in the Chicago area to open their season. Had a lopsided loss against Penn State, but a D1 victory over Brown. And then the win against D3 Washington College. That's the offense that Golden DK, originally from Spain, has been bringing so far this season.
And talking to their staff before the game, I've been really impressed at how well he can score it over either shoulder on the block.
Tyson blowing past the defender, tried to get inside on Marquise Redding. And a foul is called, and Redding picks up his first. That man is in his fifth season, Tavares Hardy. He played at Northwestern in the Princeton system his last two seasons of Bill Carmody, and that's kind of what became his constitution as a coach. Assistant at Georgia Tech, Northwestern, and Georgetown prior to becoming a head coach, and the Tigers turn it over.
I think Tavares Hardy, you know, when you look at their roster and the retention that they've had of players, it speaks to the culture that they have. Really positive, enthusiastic guys. His players love playing for him.
Tigers open up an early four-point lead. On the drive, Perry the kick. Redding tried to dump it inside, and an offensive foul is called. That time it was P.J. Hall hitting the deck.
Deion Perry got good baseline penetration, did what he does well, which is to drive it, find guys on the perimeter, kicks it right here. Marquise Redding gets downhill, unable to come to a stop, and that's the second charge we've seen the Tigers take already.
Two quick personal fouls on Marquise Redding. So he heads to the bench.
And that's been such a big start for the Tigers. Coach Brownell puts a major emphasis on not fouling in practice, and you see that in games. You've seen their opponents fouling a lot in these early November games.
Redding out of Brooklyn, New York, inside. Hall unable to get the roll. Here comes Andrews and the Greyhounds. Perry thought about it. That's Jones on the wing. They'd love to get him going. As well as Andrews, their top two scorers. They do try to use a lot of shot clock, don't they?
They do. They want to move the ball side to side. They want to get it through the high post. They're not afraid to take it late into the shot clock.
Galloway the rebound off the miss. Loyola so far, 3 of 5 from the field. Hall the open look. And it comes down to Jones.
And we see R.J. Godfrey checking into the game early for the Tigers after not showing up, not playing in the game on Friday night. I know Coach Brownell needs to get those guys off the bench some experience.
Well, he and Chauncey Wiggins, one of those, like to see get some quality minutes. Hall lost it off his leg, but Greyhounds unable to save it. Tigers will keep it on the other side of this timeout here in Little John.
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Hurry in to get our best deals of the season. Get in and get away. Get 0% APR on the 2023 Tucson, plus zero payments for 90 days. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
You can't really ignore sensitivity nor your gum issues. I would say it's very common for patients to have both. Does it worry me? Absolutely. What excited me about Sensodyne's sensitivity and gum is it really allows you to be able to take care of both issues. There's no question it's something that I would recommend.
This is 100% fresh beef with two slices of melted cheese, pickles, onions, ketchup, and mustard. This is a burger that strongly suggests you take a seat. It marks its territory, leaving behind a graveyard of napkins. And can't, no, won't be contained by humble sesame seed bun. This is the Quarter Pounder with cheese.
Hurry to get Black Friday deals now at Target. This week, save on the hottest gifts to get ahead this holiday. Event ends Saturday. Get low prices and great deals so you can holiday your way. Only at Target.
Come on, cover girls. It's time to turn it up.
Exhibitionist Stretch and Strengthen Mascara. It's an instant lash extension effect.
The best mascara I have ever used.
Exhibitionist Mascara from CoverGirl.
The new DC News Now is here.
And if you're an early riser, you're going to really like us.
We're bringing you your late news a little earlier, 9 p.m. Not too early, not too late, it's just right.
With four locations in the DMV, we're covering more ground and telling more of your stories.
The news of the day from where you live, like where you really live.
We'll see you tonight at 9 for DC News Now.
Your new choice for news, DC News Now. Tonight at 9. Check your local listings at dcnewsnow.com.
3-point lead for Clemson. The best way to get open looks is when you have good screening taking place.
So this is a fundamental set for the Tigers. It's off of a dribble handoff, and then let's freeze it right there. They're just reading this action right there between Hunter Tyson and PJ Hall. They want to see if that defender is going to go over the top or underneath. He went under it. Hunter stopped behind it, knocked down that three.
Hunter Tyson Friday night in the win, 11 points, 10 rebounds. Had a good effort right out of the gate against the Citadel, and it's good to see him make an early jumper. Brad Brownell talking before the game. He's been bothered by a nagging wrist issue, which has kind of impacted his shooting. Easy enough for Galloway on the feed from Hunter.
The Tigers have done a great job this year, especially out of those timeouts right there, being able to execute and run the set play to get a layup.
Thompson builds the lead out to 5. Andrews. Just into the game, another native of Spain, Alonso Faure, another one of their bigs. Here's Jones. Quick feed try underneath. Not a bad idea by the freshman Alexander. Tigers, though, take it away.
Tigers continue to swarm defensively right there to get a deflection. Leads to another turnover.
4 given up so far by Loyola. That's the 3rd by Clemson. Jones the pace, no look Alexander. Faure, right place, right time.
I would not say that either head coach was happy in that initial timeout. This is not the start that either one were looking for from a timeout or from a turnover standpoint, for sure. Just trying to find some sort of a rhythm offensively right now.
Tigers come into the game hitting 47% from the field, knocked away from Hall. It'll stay in this end. But you can get the percentage up when you execute plays like that.
Absolutely. Just a simple little stack action. Brevin's coming off of that curl. They're going to check that curl. And then you've got Alex Hemingway coming off right there for that stagger action right there to get that corner three. And now we see another sub. And that's part of the rhythm right now both teams are trying to get into. Josh Beadle didn't get into the game against Bellarmine. He's out there right now. And so all the substitution leads to some of the turnovers.
Ian Shefflin out there. That's him with the ball. Bullet pass inside. Something he does well. And Hemingway down low.
So much of the Tigers' ability for their post players to pass at the top of the key makes their offense effective.
Your team has been efficient for the most part in offensive sets so far this year. Faure went with a behind-the-back pass toward Jones. A reach and foul be called. Ian Shefflin, known for being able to work on the wing on both ends of the court.
Absolutely. And you mentioned the word efficiency. Coach Brownell talked about it in the post game after Friday night's win over Bellarmine. Their ability to share the basketball and take care of it leads to those good possessions and better points per possession.
Off the Clemson foul. Faure, junior, 6'10", 221. They set it up out high with Jones, who, remember, was their point guard a year ago, so when he and Perry, who has the ball now, are on the floor, they've got a couple of guys who know how to pass it. Perry can't get it to go, and there's Shefflin on the rebound.
Loyola isn't afraid to get late into the shot clock.
A little blow by Chase Hunter.
And we've seen him do that so well this year in transition, just getting his shoulders downhill to the rim.
Andrews trying to scratch the scoring column. Hemingway and the Tigers with Hunter pushing the pace. Quick spin, lost his balance. Boy, that was a scary looking play. Everyone's all right. Tyson couldn't finish. Perry gives it away. Strong move to the basket. Not going to go down for David Brown. And back and forth we go, but not a whole lot of points to show for it. The Tigers have built their largest lead of the contest. And Tyson adds to it.
The Tigers really needed that one to go down. The game has gotten a little bit frantic for both teams. We've seen some transition turnovers at the rim. But Hunter steps up and knocks down another big three.
And their close opening loss to Loyola, they did fall behind by 14, or to DePaul, rather. Loyola fell behind by 14, got within four late, and lost by six. Jones on the baseline for Fowrey. There is the scrappy Hunter Tyson. Came in with six steals on the year. Beadle. Little slide step. But the turnover. Tigers looking to add on from downtown.
Sure, and this is as much about bad transition defense by Loyola as it is good offense by Clemson. They just don't get matched up. They find Hunter right there. He knocks down the open three.
Hunter Tyson, 2 for 2 beyond the arc. Tigers off to a 2 out of 3 start in their three-pointers. Loyola 0 for 5 beyond the arc. If they have any chance tonight, they are going to have to hit some of those. We noted 37% on threes coming into this game over their first four.
And the Tigers have done a great job of rotating and getting deflections from that help side defender that has led to some of those turnovers.
DK kicked in the corner, now out on the wing, just into the ball game. Chris Kuzemka, sophomore guard, back to DK. In on Shefflin, soft touch, couldn't get the rim. Tyson, and now up court it comes with Josh Beadle from the capital city. Shefflin looks lane, instead out high. Dylan Hunter just into the contest. Hunter Tyson tries from that side. And DK the rebound.
And Dylan Hunter's a guy that Coach Brunell knows that they need to get into a rhythm, need to get him some more minutes to get him comfortable because they're going to need his help down the stretch.
Neither Jones nor Andrews have scored yet in this game. Both out on the floor. And contact inside. Shefflin able to draw the charge. DK didn't mean to, but some extra colliding going on, and then Kip Kissinger, the official, coming over. You saw him pull DK up. I don't think DK realized exactly the positioning with him and Shefflin. And take it to a timeout. Chase Hunter likes to be the hunter instead of the hunted.
Absolutely. Does a great job in transition, getting downhill, finishing at the rim. Chase Hunter at the basket.
Each year, St. Jude Children's Research Hospital works to improve the lives of kids and their families around the world. And this holiday season, Kia wants to help. We're continuing our tradition of helping others by expanding Kia's Accelerate the Good partnership with St. Jude and making a donation for every new car purchased during the holidays. Join us and help celebrate Kia's season of giving back. Kia, movement that inspires.
Cover girls, it's time to turn it up.
Exhibitionist Stretch and Strengthen Mascara. It's an instant lash extension effect.
The best mascara I have ever used.
Exhibitionist Mascara from CoverGirl.
This is 100% fresh beef. with two slices of melted cheese, pickles, onions, ketchup, and mustard. This is a burger that strongly suggests you take a seat. It marks its territory, leaving behind a graveyard of napkins. And can't, no, won't be contained by humble sesame seed bun. This is the Quarter Pounder with cheese.
Hurry to get Black Friday deals now at Target. This week, save on the hottest gifts to get ahead this holiday. Event ends Saturday. Get low prices and great deals so you can holiday your way. Only at Target.
Grandma! Walgreens Find Rx coverage is here to make Medicare easy. Even easier than those dances your grandkids love doing with you. Start Medicare shopping today with Walgreens Find Rx coverage. Plus, find low-cost copays. It's not too late to talk Medicare. Walgreens is here. Walgreens.
Nope. Nope.
You want him?
Ooh, I like him.
The Quicker Picker Upper. Bounty picks up messes quicker, and each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less.
He's an 8.
He's a 9.
Bounty, the Quicker Picker Upper.
Well, while we were away, most interesting developments here in Little John Coliseum, the Greyhounds minus a player now, as Golden DK has been ejected. He was called for the charge, and he was told to leave because he also got a technical. Remember, he made contact while lying on top of Ian Shefflin, and Shefflin's head hit the floor. Take another look. First, there was the offensive foul.
Sure. And, you know, watching it live, that's wow. Where he is right there. We didn't see that live when he swung through right there and caught Ian in the head.
And it was a charge. It was a clean holding of his ground by Shefflin, and then the flagrant.
Sure,
officials. That swing was pretty obvious when you look at it again.
Yeah, and officials are normally going to give the offensive player the benefit of the doubt on the first dribble.
Yeah.
It's the second dribble where defensively you're taught to take the charge, and Ian does a great job right there, holds his ground, takes the charge on the second one.
And that's big loss in this game for Loyola. So DK jersey off. And off the locker room he goes. He's out and leading rebounder at 6 a game, 7 points a game. Had a very good opener against DePaul. They didn't play him in their previous meeting against Washington for Maryland because they kind of just wanted to give him a rest for load management purposes. But that's a huge loss for them, especially in this contest.
No, especially with his size and his physicality. And then here's the other interesting thing about that as well. You know, the Tigers and the Greyhounds will go to Destin, Florida to play in an event later this week.
So this, in fact, is part of the Emerald Coast Classic, right. And they open it on campuses, and you go down to the Destin, Florida area.
So talking to the Greyhound staff before the game, yesterday was the start of a 6-day road trip. And so there will be some film tomorrow with Mr. DK to review that clip with Coach Hardy and the staff.
Yeah.
That will not be a fun ride to Destin. For Mr. DK.
Hunter Tyson off to a nice start, so he got the two free throws based on the technical foul, and Tyson on the season 67% now has 10 points in the game, first player in double figures, and Clemson gets the ball following the offensive foul call on DK.
So I think one of the things that's so interesting for the Tigers has been the combinations of their guards and their bigs. We see Dylan Hunter on the floor with Josh Beadle. Both of those guys are good playmakers, can handle the basketball.
Shefflin with the bucket. Ian Shefflin is first of the game. He's really provided great minutes either off the bench or at times in the starting lineup.
He really bounced back well against Bellarmine the other night. You know, he had that outstanding performance against the Citadel, and then I know that he needed to get his confidence back a little bit, and it's great to see him make that early shot tonight.
Andrews has not had many opportunities, just his second field goal attempt. He remains scoreless. Their top two scorers, Andrews averages about 14 a game. Jones just over 12, but neither in the scoring column yet. Here's Shefflin out front. Come out the big fella. 2 of 4 now on the year on threes.
And it's one of the great things in basketball. When you can start with a shot at the rim to get your confidence, now he steps out, feels good, makes that three.
Tigers lead grows to 25-8. Just saw 6 attempts from three, nothing to show for it for Loyola. Kuzemka, and they're going to get Dylan Hunter on the foul. Brad Brownell, 13th season, Clemson's all-time winningest head coach, closing in on 400 wins for his career. 10-20-win seasons for the Tigers' mentor, and a good chunk of those have come while leading this program.
And Coach Brownell really likes this team. He likes his staff. I think that's part of the reason why the South Carolina loss was so disappointing. But he feels like they're back on track now.
Kuzemka to Jones. Kick on the wing. Brown. He came in 2 of 7 beyond the arc. The lid remains on from long range. Tigers are on a 16-2 run over the past 5.5 minutes plus.
Nothing easy right now for the Greyhounds.
Shefflin. Over to Galloway.
That's an outstanding pass, though, by Ian Shefflin. Getting it across court to Brevin Galloway. Wide open three.
Just 8 points in the first 11-plus minutes for Loyola. And finally, they get a three. And Kenny Jones gets on the scoreboard. He came in at 53% beyond the arc.
Yeah, they leave him wide open. That's not going to be a clip that Clemson will like tomorrow in film. Defensive breakdown right there leaves Kenny Jones wide open.
They're just 1 of their last 8, though. Beadle inside. Tyson on the wing. Galloway. And another rebound for Faure, junior from Spain, who is going to see extended minutes tonight, obviously, with DK ejected. Lob for Faure. Good touch. Couldn't finish. Dylan Hunter. On the wing. Beadle. Tyson the rebound. Tyson made a three from there moments ago. Can't get another.
The Tigers are playing with pace right now. You know, they're not afraid to push it in transition. That's the 8th three that they've attempted. They've gotten some good looks.
Jones 38% in his career from beyond the arc. So he's getting a lot of attention tonight, and now a whistle. And a foul be called. Timeout on the court. Clemson trying to get another win against a Patriot League team. Up big on the Greyhounds.
Make way for the first ever Chevy Silverado CR2. With Multimatic shocks, rugged 33-inch tires, and front and rear electronic locking differentials.
Dude, this is awesome, but we should get back to work.
It's good.
Perfect.
If you're going to work remote, work remote. Find new workspaces. Find new roads. Chevrolet.
Technically, when enamel is gone, you cannot get it back, but there are ways you can repair it. I'm excited about Pronamel Repair because it penetrates deep into the tooth to help actively repair acid-weakened enamel. I recommend Pronamel Repair to my patients.
Scared, what I might find. I'll be safe by my side. Ain't nothing out there can't take in stride. I know. You hold me up so I can fly.
The new DC News Now is here.
And if you're an early riser, you're going to really like us.
We're bringing you your late news a little earlier, 9 p.m. Not too early, not too late. It's just right.
With 4 locations in the DMV, we're covering more ground and telling more of your stories.
The news of the day from where you live, like where you really live.
We'll see you tonight at 9 for DC News Now.
Your new choice for news, DC News Now. Tonight at 9. Check your local listings at dcnewsnow.com.
There are all kinds of products in this world, things that make life easier. Or more fun. But New York Life's product is different. It's 12,000 experts whose responsibility is to be there to guide you through the happiest and most difficult times. People who know the most valuable things in life aren't things at all. This is our product. This is what we do.
Tigers with a 14-point lead on Loyola. You know, JD, when I was a kid, I saw a coach make his team run sets without ever dribbling the ball. Tigers just did that in the game.
The Tigers do a great job of sharing the basketball. They're currently third in the ACC at 16 assists per game. I think it's the best thing that they do offensively. They're very unselfish. They create for others. It all started with a skip pass from a ball screen roll by Ian Shefflin. Did a great job moving around the perimeter, and they get a layup.
So in that case, there was one dribble, but six passes around it, and Clemson doing the good things fundamentally.
And Chase
was
Hunter
on Shefflin, by the way, before the timeout.
Sure, and Chase Hunter just continues to create for his teammates.
There's a guy that if he gets hot, he's going to get his team right back in the ball game.
And that's back-to-back made threes by Kenny Jones, so he's starting to get comfortable.
They had started 0 for 6 as a team beyond the arc. Chauncey Wiggins just into the contest for Clemson. Hall inside, double dribble. Marquis Redding, who picked up two quick fouls when he came off the bench early on, defending that time, and it'll go the other way.
And Loyola will play Redding at the five some to go small. But I love that Chauncey Wiggins is here in the first half. It's a guy that we've got to get minutes to and help him get comfortable.
Five turnovers for Clemson team that averaged under 10 per game at the start of the night. Chance to get this down inside of a double-digit deficit for Loyola.
And that was so much of Clemson's success on Friday night. Only 9 turnovers in a low possession count game. Coach Brownell knows they've got to take care of the ball.
And that'll be a shot clock violation as Jones missed everything.
Outstanding defensive possession right there. Led them to a shot clock violation. Those are the kind of clips that when your team is together the next day, you want to show those clips because they generate great enthusiasm from your team.
Brad Brownell, his first time facing the Baltimore school. Saw his team race out to a 17-point advantage early on. Hall fed low. Kicked out high to Galloway. Hemingway loves to shoot it from there, and that's why.
And again, it all started with a skip pass. Chauncey Wiggins called it in the post, skipped it. One more, wide open three.
5 points for Hemingway. His three-pointer makes it a 28-14 game. That's his first of the night. Galloway on the takeaway, pushing the pace. Hemingway, he can throw it down as well.
The Tigers turning turnovers into offense. Able to get out and run. Brevin Galloway finds Alex Hemingway right there for the layup at the rim. Outstanding job by the Tigers right there, being able to create offense off of their defense.
The winter sun. It's a ticking clock. Where shorter days mean a precious countdown has begun. So chase the sun and seize the season, because when the days are at their shortest, it's on us to make them the fullest.
Get 3.79% APR for 60 months on most 2023 Cadillac models. Visit your local Cadillac dealer today.
Grandma! Walgreens Find Rx coverage is here to make Medicare easy. Even easier than those dances your grandkids love doing with you. Start Medicare shopping today with Walgreens Find Rx coverage. Plus, find low-cost copays. It's not too late to talk Medicare. Walgreens is here. Walgreens.
Alex Hemingway benefiting from the fact the Tigers turn defense into quick offense. Brevin Galloway, good vision.
Yeah, and I think Alex Hemingway is such a key guy for the Tigers. When he's playing well offensively, it gives them another scoring option. They need him to play well.
Hunter Tyson leads Clemson with 10. Hemingway now has 7. Tigers just like that, back up by 16, led by a quick 25-8 margin. Loyola trying to hang in. Fifth season for their head coach, Tavares Hardy, who called the timeout. He says they've kind of had a reboot this year. They're being patient in this fifth season with a shot clock now under 5. They think they're building something. Fade away. That does catch the net for Jones. And a good job by Hunter on the rebound.
And Tavares Hardy has done an outstanding job at Loyola. Took him to the championship game in his third season. They're continuing to build there.
They've got a list of former coaches. That's impressive. From behind came Brown. Let's see what the call is inside as Andrews also hit the deck, but he'll be called for the block.
And Coach Hardy is a guy that's obviously familiar with Clemson from his time with Josh Pastner at Georgia Tech. Brevin Galloway right here in the ball screen getting downhill. That's one of those 50-50 calls that could go either way. You'd probably rather Brevin play off at 2 feet right there and find that dump down. But instead he gets fouled and gets to the free throw line.
Brevin Galloway in double figures in each game so far in his Clemson career at 14 the other night against Bellarmine.
And I think his ability to attack the rim has been the best thing that he's done this year. He kind of settled into a catch-and-shoot guy. He's become much more aggressive off the dribble to the basket.
And he's an 84% free throw shooter. 18-point advantage. Inside and rejected Perry.
And so
the big fella comes out of it.
Yeah, Chauncey Wiggins, that's why he's so valuable as a young guy. He's able to clean up that mistake. And then he finishes it on the other end. Well-timed.
Chauncey Wiggins, long and athletic, 6'10", 205, out of Grayson, Georgia, just outside of Atlanta. Good high school program.
Chauncey's a skilled guy. He can make a three. Obviously, he's long and athletic. He can guard a lot of positions. He's got a bright future.
20-point Clemson lead, their biggest of the opening half. Brown tries again from outside. Nice box out by Hall.
And he missed that shot right there, but Coach Brownell and those guys on the staff will not be happy about that defensive possession. They screwed up the switch right there.
Won't be happy with Jones taking it away. Kicks it on the wing. Tyson Commander stepped out of bounds. He gave him some instant offense the other day. Tigers got some instant offense off of their defense. Wiggins the rejection, and he was more than happy to get it back on the other end.
Yeah, it's a great job creating for a teammate right there. You know, Brevin Galloway again gets downhill. He finds Chauncey at the rim for the easy finish.
PJ Hall. Now Hunter looking inside for the cutting Hall. How about Wiggins from the outside?
And that's a shot that you're okay with. You know, the young guy's trying to get comfortable, building his confidence. He feels good right now. He got 10 minutes in Friday's win against Bellarmine. They want to build on that tonight.
Another deflection in the lane by a Tiger, that time by Hall. Jones was trying to get it to foul rate. Clemson on a 9-0 run over the past 2.5 minutes.
The Tigers have done a great job flooding to the basketball when the ball's been driven. They're getting their hands on a lot of those dump-down passes.
Perry defending his fellow freshman Hunter. Hemingway, good scoring first half for him. Hall from out front. And the Tigers will retreat.
So right now, Coach Brownell, the staff, they're talking about finishing this 4 minutes well. You know, 14 points. They want to finish this half defensively well, want to close this out well so that they can go into the locker room feeling good about it defensively. That's a great start right there.
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Hurry in to get our best deals of the season. Get in and get away. Get 0% APR on the 2023 Tucson, plus zero payments for 90 days. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
Let's dive in.
What about your back?
It's fine!
Advil Dual Action fights pain two ways. Advil targets pain at the source. Acetaminophen blocks pain signals. Advil Dual Action.
You spent your life carefully building a legacy. We'll be just as careful helping you pass it on.
The new DC News Now is here.
And if you're an early riser, you're going to really like us.
We're bringing you your late news a little earlier, 9 p.m. Not too early, not too late, it's just right.
With four locations in the DMV, we're covering more ground and telling more of your stories.
The news of the day from where you live, like where you really live.
We'll see you tonight at 9 for DC News Now.
Your new choice for news, DC News Now. Tonight at 9. Check your local listings at dcnewsnow.com.
Number one.
cars are like aircraft, but upside down. They're creating lift, but they're creating lift in the opposite sense. We're pushing the tires into the ground.
The only bit that actually touches the ground are the tires. So as much downforce as you can have, it's just key to going faster through those phases.
Aerodynamics is the prime performance differentiator on a Formula One car. So that's also why we dedicate a lot of resource, a lot of focus on aerodynamics.
Yo soy mago, desaparezco. Cuentas están plenas. Está muy fuerte como.
Chase Hunter, we talked about him in our open, and that just gives you an idea as to the leap he has made from last year to this.
Sure, Chase is off to a great start right now. He's eighth in the ACC in scoring at 17.8 points per game. Obviously, his three-point shooting is off the charts at 70%. But I tell you, the stat that really stands out to me is his assist-to-turnover ratio. So much of what the Tigers do offensively is predicated off of him being able to get in the lane. He's a very unselfish player. He sets guys up for easy shots at the rim, and that makes their job easier.
With J.D. Powell, Pete Hannity here in Little John Coliseum. Clemson trying to get a fourth win in this building on the season and go to 4-1 overall before heading down for a couple of games against Iowa to start out down in the Destin, Florida area.
Sure, and talking to the staff even before the game, before warm-ups, you know, the Iowa game is going to be a huge test for the Tigers on Friday.
Oh, inside Tyson on the nice feed.
Great pass again right there by the Tigers, finding them right there at the rim.
Josh Beadle, pretty feed for him. Clemson on quite the impressive run. Feed inside, knocked away. Garrett Brennan able though to kick it out to Perry. And look at the leaping ability by Commander. Keeps the possession alive. Andrews still without a point. Leads them in scoring. He'll try again over Tyson. And the rebound by Middlebrooks.
And that's the great thing about Hunter Tyson. They set that ball screen. He's able to switch it.
Right there. Look at a little hesitation move and a foul. Check out Tyson.
And so much of the development for Hunter Tyson has been his physicality around the rim. Obviously, he's open right there for the easy dunk. But on that last possession where he gets fouled, you know, he's done a great job this year of running to the rim, sealing, posting low. It's led to free throws. It's been a big part of the Tigers' offense right now.
Tyson came in at 67% on free throws on the year. He made a couple earlier when he got to shoot them because of the technical.
And I'm sure if you ask Hunter Tyson, that's a statistic he would like to improve upon. You know, he's going to get fouled. He wants to be a guy that can go over there. He needs to be above 72%.
Two more free throws for Hunter Tyson. His good night continues. Now has 14 in the contest. Earlier this season, against Penn State and State College, Loyola lost 90-65. They trailed by only 11 at the half, but this is going to be a sizable deficit at the break, regardless of what happens over the final 227, you would suppose.
Sure, and Coach Hardy, the Chicago native, prides himself on how hard they play, how competitive they are. We've talked about the DePaul game, Penn State, but they have not gotten off to a great start offensively in the first half. And a lot of that credit goes to the Tigers, their job creating those deflections.
Jones looks back door, feeds Andrews, and Beadle came over to defend, held ball, and the arrow will give it back to Clemson.
And so much of that right there on that possession. You see Ian Shiflin coming over from the help side, and he didn't foul. That's such a huge part of college basketball right now, the analytics of not allowing your opponent to get to the free throw line. He stayed vertical.
Beadle getting some extended minutes in the opening half. Jones, fifth-year senior, came in averaging just over 12 a game, has six in the opening half. He said there were only 2 3-pointers. Pass inside, another turnover by Loyola. Those have been adding up. That is number 12 in the game. They're 0 for their last six. Tigers are on a 13-0 run in better than 4 minutes.
And a good job by R.J. Godfrey being in position right there, being disciplined on that back cut.
Shiflin gets it out high to feed Beadle. Instead, he'll give it to Dylan Hunter. Well, a young group out there right now. A couple of true freshmen. A sophomore with the ball. A redshirt freshman to his left. Godfrey. And he'll go to the line.
Outstanding post-to-post passing by the Tigers right there. Ian Scheffling catches it at the elbow, throws it down low to the big, strong freshman, R.J. Godfrey. And you mentioned the young guys on the floor. Coach Brownell talked about it after the game on Friday night. He knows he's got to get those guys more minutes now in November.
Three-star performer out of North Gwinnett High School near Atlanta. Godfrey making his mark on the defensive end.
And we talked about being disciplined right there. You know, he's staying in between his man and the rim. There's that back cut that Loyola loves to run. R.J. Godfrey snaps his head, gets his hand out, leads to a turnover.
One of two for the 6'7 freshman. Averaged 16 points and 9 rebounds a game in his senior season in high school. Here's another freshman, Perry. Now Commander driving on Beadle. Clemson nearly 40 points in this opening half. And looking like they're going to hold Loyola under 20. Perry forcing it. And Godfrey the rebound. He's showing you some ball handling as he brings it up court.
Absolutely. R.J. Godfrey's a skilled guy. He can play away from the basket. Able to start the break after the rebound.
Quickly to Beadle from Hunter. Good passing by the Tigers. Crossover. Minute to go in the half. Beadle no. Battle for the rebound. Tigers will keep it.
Tigers continue to do a great job skipping the ball across the floor, making those closeouts a little bit longer for the Greyhounds.
Dylan Hunter, who could be playing a bigger role at point guard as the season goes on, and looks to enhance his scoring opportunities as well.
Sure, and he's a freshman that Coach Brownell and the staff are really high on. They know that they've got to continue to get him more involved and help him build some confidence.
Follow Loyola wondering where Golden DK, their best post player, is. He was ejected earlier following a technical foul that time. Fowrey unable to finish inside. The drought continues for the Greyhounds. Tigers will play for a final shot here in the opening half.
Really good finish to the half defensively for the Tigers. Coach Brownell and the staff will be excited about that.
Hunter in the lane. Gets the roll. 43-14, a heave by Perry, and that's how halftime arrives. A dominant opening 20 minutes for the Clemson Tigers, who are 3-0 this season when leading at the break. Big hill to climb for that man, Tavares Hardy, and his Greyhounds. Tigers trying for a third straight win. Looking good so far.
Find out where that road leads. Take on any challenge. When you have the number one brand and dependability, you stop thinking about what you can't do and start doing what you never thought possible. Kia, movement that inspires.
Change your Gatorade, bro.
Yes, sir. For punch. I remember way
back when. Back in the days when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore.
Cindy McLaughlin has done it. And everybody saying, I remember way back when.
Start playing and never stop playing. You get the most from the game when you're having fun. I remember way back
when. Hi, my name is Jackie, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the whipped cream and the cherry on top. It's like a little bow on top of this great present of peppermint chip goodness. The best way I can describe it to people is that it tastes like the holidays.
Hi, I'm Jordan. A little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the peppermint bark. It reminds me of peppermint bark that my grandmother used to make. It's the perfect crunch that sparks holiday joy. It's holiday-licious.
Yo soy mago, desaparezco. Cuentas tan plenas, está muy fuerte como.
The future is threatened by enemies often unseen.
They alert Marines.
And unexpected. In the midst of an uncertain and evolving world, the need for Marines to defeat these shifting threats is critical, because the need to ensure stability for our nation has never been greater. When there are battles to win for America's future, there is one constant: Marines.
On December 16th, the motion picture event of a generation arrives. Avatar: The Way of Water. Experience it in 3D. Tickets on sale now.
See yourself in the Lululemon Studio Mirror with more than 10,000 workouts. Led by world-class instructors. Featuring guest fitness studios like Pure Bar, Rumble, and more. Your perfect workout is waiting in the ultimate home gym. So join in now and see yourself move in the Lululemon Studio Mirror.
For the ninth time during Brad Brownell's run here at Clemson, the Tigers hold a team to below 20 points in the opening half of play, 43-14. A dominant performance so far with J.D. Powell, Pete Gannady with you back in Little John Coliseum. I'm impressed with points over turnovers. 12 of the 43 points for Clemson came that way. And just the fact that Loyola, a team that has shown some flashes offensively over their first four games, never had any rhythm.
No, they didn't. And so much of that was because of the Tigers' help side defense. Most of the deflections came from the off-ball defender. When the ball was driven, he rotated down. They tried to make a pass. He got his hand in the passing lane. It led to a turnover.
I think when you look back in this game, the three-point defense for Clemson, very impressive. 41% when the night began. That's going to go way down after Loyola in the opening half was 2 of 13 beyond the arc. That's one of the things that steps out off the stat sheet at me defensively.
Sure. So much of that's about guarding the basketball. You know, so the Tigers were able to guard the ball. It allows them to stay home with shooters on the perimeter. They're able to get out and contest and challenge shots. The Greyhounds did not get very many open threes.
Hunter Tyson, 14 points to lead Clemson, but the only double-figure scorer when a team was able to manage 43 points in 20 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely, and that speaks to how the Tigers shared the basketball. You know, 10 assists so far, only 6 turnovers, multiple guys involved creating shots for teammates.
Take a look at the first half stats, and you will see many good things for the home team, including a solid effort, 55% from the field.
Sure, and so much of that were the points of paint. They were able to get layups, get the ball out in transition, some turnovers that led to some easy shots at the rim, making it a little simpler.
Tigers close the opening half on an 18-0 run over the final 6:27. We're going to take a look at various superlatives and what's happening around the ACC when we continue at halftime here in Little John.
There's never been a better time to get away. With a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Hurry in to get our best deals of the season. Get in and get away.
Get 0% APR on the 2023 Santa Fe. Plus zero payments for 90 days. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
Start playing and never stop playing. You get the most from the game when you're having fun.
Hi, my name is Jackie, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the whipped cream and the cherry on top. It's like a little bow on top of this great present of peppermint chip goodness. The best way I can describe it to people is that it tastes like the holidays.
Hi, I'm Jordan. A little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the peppermint bark. It reminds me of peppermint bark that my grandmother used to make. It's the perfect crunch that sparks holiday joy. It's holiday-licious.
Yo soy mago. Desaparezco. Cuentas tan plenas.
The idea of safety can be overwhelming. How do you secure your future? For over 75 years, WEPA's Group Term Life Insurance has helped civilian federal employees. To learn more, visit WEPA.org.
At Charmin, we're all about the science of softness. So, we doubly tested our Charmin Ultra Soft to prove its value really stacks up.
First up, the cushy soft test. Wow!
softer than ever. Next, the absorbency test.
See, it's 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less. So, Charmin UltraSoft is always worth it.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have one more test to conduct.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
Halftime continues here in Little John Coliseum, this first ever meeting between the Tigers and Loyola Greyhounds from Baltimore, Maryland. As we welcome you back in, well, with J.D. Powell, Pete Hannity, and let's take a look at how the ACC is doing as far as the national rankings go. Sure, it's earlier in the season, but the league is well represented.
Absolutely. I think the big storyline early in the year right now in the ACC has been Virginia. You know, Tony Bennett and his team has risen quickly. Playing well, obviously, will always defend at half court. After a really emotional week in Charlottesville, that's been a bright spot for the fans up there.
And no doubt the ACC will be well represented in the rankings as the season goes on. All conference teams announced about a month ago, and you see that Baycott and Love lead the way. Isaiah Wong, I've always thought, is a very underappreciated player from Miami.
Yeah, and I really like the win that Miami got the other night at Providence. Providence was a really good team, won the Big East regular season championship last year. And so for Miami to go on the road and get that win, that's huge for those guys.
Second team, P.J. Hall, who since his return almost looks like he's in midseason form. So good to see the Tiger big man really coming back nicely from his offseason knee issue. As for some news and notes from around the conference, two guys you would expect to be right up there in scoring are for North Carolina.
Armando Baycott is off to a great start for the Tar Heels. He continues to develop his body. He's moving well right now. He's obviously outstanding at the rim, and the Tar Heels are off to a great start.
And, of course, the Clemson Tigers ever so close to being part of the undefeated, but still 5 in the conference without a loss.
Absolutely, and that's the thing that's tricky. You know, you wish you had that one basket back, but the Tigers are going to have plenty of opportunities on the schedule coming up over the next couple months.
With the expanded conference schedule that came into effect not long ago, you've got earlier ACC games now than really ever before, and December 2nd it begins. Steve Forbes and Wake Forest will be in Little John Coliseum. Really, by the turn of the year, you'll have a good idea as to how you might size up, at least for the early part of ACC play.
Absolutely, Pete. And the thing that stands out to me about the Tigers ACC schedule in December are the games that you feel like you can maybe go steal one on the road, and then you got to protect home court. It all starts on December 2nd. Whenever Steve Forbes and the Demon Deacons come in here, they need to find a way to play well in that one.
Tigers will have that early opportunity for Christmas at Georgia Tech. We come back with more. Halftime continues. Tigers and Loyola in Thanksgiving week. Back after this.
Each year, St. Jude Children's Research Hospital works to improve the lives of kids and their families around the world. And this holiday season, Kia wants to help. We're continuing our tradition of helping others by expanding Kia's Accelerate the Good partnership with St. Jude and making a donation for every new car purchased during the holidays. Join us and help celebrate Kia's season of giving back. Kia, movement that inspires.
What can I do for you, man?
Really craving nacho fries.
Ads are working.
What ads?
Oh, like all the pictures I put over here in the bedroom. I put that there.
The new DC News Now is here.
And if you're an early riser, you're gonna really like us.
We're bringing you your late news a little earlier, 9 p.m. Not too early, not too late, it's just right.
With 4 locations in the DMV, we're covering more ground and telling more of your stories.
The news of the day from where you live, like where you really live.
We'll see you tonight at 9 for DC News Now.
Your new choice for news, DC News Now. Tonight at 9, check your local listings at dcnewsnow.com.
Yo soy mago, desaparezco. Cuentas están plenas. Está muy fuerte como.
Hey, Peloton, step into your power. Let's go.
Ah, you didn't come to work out. You came to outwork. Let's get it.
Yo. Boom. 2+3=4.
Come on, you got this.
Every day, man's on the
hey.
Block.
No challenge, no change.
The tingles.
Let's go.
Get up to $300 off accessories. Terms apply.
Are you the one others rally around?
inspire soldiers to follow your lead. Want to forge a better future? Start with the structures that support tomorrow's missions. You believe the best offense is a good defense. We've got a great way to prove that theory. See your vision clearly, get there decisively. Explore more than 200 careers at GoArmy.com.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket.
I love how Cricket has no hidden fees, no hidden charges. It's just predictable.
With Cricket, I can stay in touch with my grandson as much as I want without being concerned that my bills go up.
The 5G is like fast, fast. It makes sharing photos of our projects and video calls super easy.
Switch for the speed, stay for the savings. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Tigers in control at the half, getting ready for half number two here in Little John with J.D. Powell, Pete Hannity. Welcome back in as Clemson goes for a third straight win. An impressive first half. We talked about it early on. Brad Brownell wants to see his team in a holiday week with a trip to Florida coming up. Stay engaged. You wonder if that's going to be a challenge up by nearly 30 points coming out of the locker room.
He's going to play young guys in the second half. He knows those guys need that valuable experience. And he didn't feel like they came out of the locker room well on Friday night against Bellarmine. And so these first 4 to 8 minutes are really critical to get into a routine, particularly defensively.
Plenty of highlights in the opening half. We told you Hunter Tyson, the only player in double figures scoring with 14. He did a lot of things well, though, in that first half of play.
Sure, he knocked down these two big threes right here. The first one on this ball reversal. The second one comes right here. He's going to take this charge, first of two that he took. You know, we've talked about it a lot. You know, Hunter Tyson makes so many plays that don't show up in the stat sheet that just make you better. But even right there, cutting without the basketball, getting that easy dunk at the rim, continues to have a great half. And then Alex Hemenway, you know, as I've said, I really feel like he's a guy that when he's playing well for the Tigers, gives them another score, and he's had back-to-back really good games now. Came into it shooting well, having another good night tonight.
Alex Hemenway in the opening half of play was 7 points. Looking good. One of the guys who's become a leader on this team, Newberg, Indiana native. And as you see, his shooting has always been a big part of the story, particularly from beyond the arc.
It has. He didn't get off to the start that he wanted to this season. He had a great trip in France. He led the Tigers in scoring, but then got off to a slow start from three. But the last three games, he's really shot the ball well, just over 50%, has continued that tonight. Now as the Tigers get ready to go to Destin to take on the Iowa Hawkeyes, he's playing confident.
In the first half, Clemson, 10 assists, 6 turnovers. And that number actually really quieted down because early Clemson had a handful of quick turnovers, but a team playing efficiently coming in, under 10 turnovers a game while forcing about 14. Stay on that pace once you get into conference play, and that's going to be a really good formula.
They only turned it over 9 times against Bellarmine on Friday night, and Coach Brownell talked about it in his post-game press conference. They have to be efficient. So much of that for them is taking care of the basketball and then making their free throws. So right now, only the 6 turnovers. That'll be a number we can watch in the second half as these young guys get more minutes.
I thought it was interesting the other night they were even in points in the paint with the ASUN opponent, Bellarmine. Tonight, 22-6 in the paint. Another big part of the story. And so many times they have also denied any opportunities close to the basket. On the defensive end have the Tigers, who get the ball first. P.J. Hall starts on the floor in the second half, and the big fella uses the glass.
The post-to-post passing of the Tigers again. Hunter Tyson goes high-low, finds P.J. He's able to turn to that left shoulder jump hook.
First field goal of the night. The run continues.
And it's an interesting trend by Coach Brownell. He doesn't start P.J. Hall in the first half, but he does in the second half again for the third straight game.
Andrews, their leading scorer. No points so far. Both Tyson and Hall on the defense, but Clemson, I believe, unable to save it.
Great high-low pass by Hunter Tyson. The Clemson bigs shoot the ball well enough that you have to come up and guard them, and that allows them to find those high-low looks and get those points in the paint.
Deion Perry gets it in. Alexander, freshman athletic player for him out of Bronx, New York. You saw him with the ball moments ago. He was quiet in the opening half as well.
Really long, talented freshman. Had a great outing against Washington College the other night. Trying to find a rhythm tonight against the Tigers.
Foul Ray, 2 on the shot clock. goes around Hall. Nice job by the Spaniard.
Yeah, and Spain has been good to the Loyola Greyhounds. You know, Coach Hardy's been able to do a great job there recruiting, brought in multiple guys, including a current NBA player.
They've got a guy starting for the Grizzlies right now, Santi Aldama, and they also lost a player who could have come back last year, a good scorer for them, who transferred to Rutgers. And they don't take grad, they don't take any kind of transfers, be they grad transfers or in the portal, as the turnover for the Tigers, Galloway. And so no transfers, I mean, that's the philosophy that is common around this campus in another sport.
Sure, absolutely. We've seen the benefits of that, and it speaks to Coach Hardy's culture of his program.
Patriot League school, they've been in the Patriot for about a decade. They used to be in the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference with teams like Iona and Fairfield, and they had success in that conference, but they moved to the Patriot where Colgate's the favorite, Holy Cross, American. Oh, what a nice feed inside. And that's the point guard part of Kenny Jones getting the bucket for Fowery.
Absolutely. Led the Patriot League in assists per game last season. Came off of that ball screen, able to find Fowery on the roll.
Chase Hunter, the pull-up. So smooth this year. We told you about his gaudy number beyond the arc, and he came in shooting 51% overall from the field.
Sure, that's a little bit too easy right there. The Greyhounds are too far back in that ball screen. Chase hits that easy pull-up.
Fowrey feeling it. Hall the foul. Alonzo Fowrey battled injuries really throughout last season. Came in averaging 9 points a game. Let's check out the other end. Chase Hunter, I think he's really added this dimension to his game on this level recently.
Sure, we've talked a lot about this right here. He plays with great pace. He never gets into a hurry. He plays, he gets to his spot right there, knocks down that pull-up. But going back to the defensive end for the Tigers, we've seen this a couple of times. They came out of the locker room. The Greyhounds have gotten it to the rim three straight times now. Coach Brownell and staff, Coach Donlin, will not be happy about that.
There's 14 points in the first half. Fowrey has brought them on the verge of 20. Among his hidden talents, he is a skilled piano player. So by gosh, he can play some hoops and then entertain his teammates with a tune or two.
A man of many talents. He had 18 points against Washington College the other night, playing confident here in the second half.
Now he defends Hall, and he'll pick up the foul.
Great job by P.J. Hall right there, getting that initial post position. Able to move right there, draws the foul. He will get to the free throw line.
First on Fowrey and on the Greyhounds here in half number two. P.J. Hall activated in the second game of the year, the trip to Columbia. 73% so far from the line. Always solid in that regard.
So much of what the Dorman High School native does well is the skill part of the game. He is an outstanding passer from the top of the key. He can make a three, but then when he gets fouled, he goes to the free throw line and he knocks it down.
Comes from quite an athletic family, and he is doing his part, holding up his end of the deal. Hadn't scored in the first half, now has a field goal and a couple of free throws here in the second half of play.
Says a lot for the 29. Tigers when you can play that well in the first half and he hasn't scored.
Reports Fowrey, Jones. Jones had just two the other night. They rested their veteran players. From the corner, the freshman Alexander. Now 2 of 6 in his collegiate career from long range.
Alexander has great length on the perimeter, can shoot the basketball well, jumped up right there and was able to knock down that three. This is a big 20 minutes for the Greyhounds.
Tyson defended by Alexander. Hunter had a chance to think about it, fires a three. Brad Brownell will call the timeout as the lead builds to 52-23. Now the Clemson Tigers showing the rhythm of the first half here early in the second half. Convincing lead to this point.
The winter sun, it's a ticking clock. Where shorter days mean a precious countdown has begun. So chase the sun and seize the season, because when the days are at their shortest, it's on us to make them the fullest.
Get 3.79% APR for 60 months on most 2023 Cadillac models. Visit your local Cadillac dealer today.
Come on, CoverGirls. It's time to turn it up.
Exhibitionist Stretch and Strengthen Mascara. It's an instant lash extension effect.
The best mascara I have ever used.
Exhibitionist Mascara.
from CoverGirl.
The new DC News Now is here.
And if you're an early riser, you're going to really like us.
We're bringing you your late news a little earlier, 9 p.m. Not too early, not too late. It's just right.
With four locations in the DMV, we're covering more ground and telling more of your stories.
The news of the day from where you live, like where you really live.
We'll see you tonight at 9 for DC News Now.
Your new choice for news, DC News Now. Tonight at 9. Check your local listings at dcnewsnow.com.
Hurry to get Black Friday deals now at Target. This week, save on the hottest gifts to get ahead this holiday. Event ends Saturday. Get low prices and great deals so you can holiday your way. Only at Target.
Quiet.
When I told Pity Tony, listen to my tone, you ain't catching you a Tony. Award winning walk when you running with a shiny. Why you running from us? Why you messing with us? Maybe polar. You ain't ready, ready, roll up. Pull up machete, cut the bamboo paper. Let's roll out, baby, loud, Frankie.
What I want.
This holiday, you can gift more and spend less at TJ Maxx, Marshalls, and HomeGoods with more cheer to go around and more joy for your money.
And Doug.
It's nice to unwind after a long week of telling people how Liberty Mutual customizes your car insurance so you only pay for what you need.
Showtime.
Woo! I'm on fire tonight.
Yes! Remo, you're a natural.
We're not counting that.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
We suppose Brad Brownell called that timeout because he wasn't happy with what was going on the defensive end for his team. Here's what it looked like as he chatted with him.
And we talked about it, Pete, at halftime. You know, Coach Brownell wants them to be able to come out and play a full 40 minutes. He doesn't feel like they're there yet. So he calls that timeout. Loyola comes out of the locker room, goes 3 of 3 from the field, doesn't turn the basketball over. They're able to find some flow offensively.
P.J. Hall and the Tigers back on the floor. Keep in mind, Clemson scored 43 points in the opening half. He didn't score one. He's got 4 in the second half. But I think it's really important that this team becomes more than just P.J. Hall once ACC play arrives.
Sure, and you spoke of the lead, and they did that in only one guy in double figures, so it speaks to how well they've spread the basketball around. But P.J. is going to need some help.
Loyola trying to hang in there. Alexander again from the corner. And there's Hunter Tyson. Foure, good hustle by the big guy.
Again, they get the miss. Got a defensive rebound.
No for Perry. Skying for the rebound was Andrews. Foure can't finish. Tough night for Jalen Andrews.
Yeah, it has been. And the Tigers gave up 3 offensive rebounds right there. So much of this half right here for both coaches is going to be about getting your team better. Whether it's Coach Hardy as they get ready for Southern on Friday or the Tigers as they get ready for Iowa on Friday.
Foure held his ground. Hall unable to convert. Perry, Foure, and inside, late whistle, the foul is called. P.J. Hall will pick up the personal. Another timeout on the court here in Little John.
There's never been a better time to get away with a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Hurry in to get our best deals of the season. Get in and get away. Get 0% APR on the 2023 Tucson, plus 0 payments for 90 days. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
You can't really ignore sensitivity nor your gum issues. I would say it's very common for patients to have both. Does it worry me? Absolutely. What excited me about Sensodyne's sensitivity and gum is it really allows you to be able to take care of both issues. There's no question it's something that I would recommend.
People would fail to.
You keep helping her with homework.
But we're only just now.
We'll help you save for her college.
What if you were a global energy company with operations in Scotland,
technologists in India, and customers all on different systems. You need to pull it together. So you call in IBM and Red Hat to create an open hybrid cloud platform. Now data is available anywhere securely. And your digital transformation is helping find new ways to unlock energy around the world. IBM, let's create. IBM, let's create.
Formula One cars are like aircraft but upside down. Formula One cars are like aircraft but upside down. They're creating lift, but they're creating lift in the opposite sense. We're pushing the tires into the ground.
The only bit that actually touches the ground are the tires. So as much downforce as you can have, it's just key to going faster through those phases.
Aerodynamics is the prime performance differentiator on a Formula One car. So that's also why we dedicate a lot of resource, a lot of focus on aerodynamics.
Final trailer, Avatar, The Way of Water, during Monday Night Football, only on ESPN.
You're helping her study for a geography test, but how can you think about states and cities?
When a burger with steak, butter, and bacon sounds like the best, with grilled onions and two slices of cheese, father-daughter cheeseburgers, what's better than that? She's about to find out, you can't read a map. Sonic steak, butter, bacon, cheeseburger.
Sonic.
The woman sitting in the middle on the Loyola bench, Corinne Tiny Adams, very unique status in the men's college game. She is the only female assistant coach. She's one of the three assistants for Tavares Hardy in all of Division I men's basketball, roughly 360 teams. She has a great basketball acumen and a fantastic career as a player, but the lone assistant coach, there were two, but now she is the only one female assistant coach on a men's team.
Sure, and this is the future of our game. We're seeing it in the NBA. Becky Hammon is the best example. She was an assistant for Greg Popovich with the San Antonio Spurs. We're seeing it a lot right now in the NBA. So credit to Coach Hardy, you know, brought her on staff 3 years ago. She was the all-time leading scorer at Morgan State. And watching her with her team, they listen. They listen when she tells them something, whether it's in the sideline or in the scout. She does an outstanding job.
Fowre having a good second half scoring. Greyhounds were down by 29 at the break here, within 28. And Alexander looking to knock it away from Tyson will be called for the foul. And you look where they come from, Baltimore.
Sure, let's get
it. D1 team, so the
great
entry
feed.
Pass right there.
Mm-hmm. Great feed by the Tigers out of the timeout, posting Hunter Tyson.
Chase Hunter, and now another foul will be called. Feels against Zion Perry. Three on the Greyhounds team, and Chase Hunter will go to the line. Second on the Tigers, coming in 75%. So we talked about Tiny Adams, the assistant playing in Morgan State. You look at the landscape in the Baltimore area, a bunch of D1 schools outside of their conference. Greyhounds can have a lot of short road trips. UMBC, which made NCAA tourney history a couple of years ago, is just down the street from them. Towson State, out on the north side in the city of Towson, just north of Baltimore. Coppin State, Morgan State, and then two teams in their conference, Navy and American, aren't far away. Then obviously in D.C. you've got Howard, Georgetown, George Washington.
And I think that Coach Hardy's experience at Georgetown has been such a huge part of his success at Loyola, being able to recruit that DMV area.
A lot of basketball talent there. Hall knocking it away from Fowre. Tigers matching their biggest lead of the night. And a foul on the block. Galloway, the guilty party.
So all those possessions defensively that the Tigers had well in the first half, they're looking for them right now in the second. Brevin Galloway is late right there on that ball screen roll rotation. That's about the third time that we've seen that this half. And Coach Brownell is not going to be happy about that.
Fowre getting added minutes tonight. Golden DK, their starting post player, ejected following a technical foul, and he's scrapped with Ian Shefflin in the opening half.
His physicality at the rim has given the Tigers problems here in the early going in the second half.
Cross court pass, Galloway. Lost the handle, knocked away by Perry. Scrappy backcourt for this Loyola team. Fowray again looking to build on a good second half. Looked like he might have walked.
But again, his physicality, he's able to seal Ian shuffling up the lane and get an angle. Tigers are a little bit late on that baseline rotation again.
Fowray, 13 points. Doing his damage after the intermission.
And he's coming off of an 18-point performance against Washington College the other night, so his confidence is growing.
Galloway, quick pass to Hunter. Bad miss. Loyola trailed by 29 points moments ago. They've had really no run of any kind in this game. They managed only 14 points in the opening half. They're about to exceed that if they can score on this drive, on this possession.
And that's where it's tricky for the Tigers. You know, you held them to 14 points, but you want to continue to play well defensively.
From the outside, Commander. And Shefflin, another rebound. Shefflin looking inside. Hunter Tyson couldn't find the handle, pushing the pace. Commander scooping. Alexander couldn't get the rebound. Tyson for the Tigers.
And that's back-to-back turnovers now for Clemson, so they want to try to get a good possession right here.
Nice idea, getting it to Tyson, and a good try, good offensive rebound. Second time, not the charm. Well, I thought that one was on its way in the first attempt.
Great pass on that ball screen roll. Hunter just unable to finish it at the rim.
Notice that Jones playing a lot out high now as they're trying to get back in this game. Slowing the pace, just trying to get their breath. Commander moving on Hemingway. Shot clock again coming up on five. Commander in the lane. Ball hit the rim, play continues.
Tigers trying to find a rhythm here in the second half. Have turned it over on multiple possessions.
Kicking on the wing, Hunter for Tyson. Clemson now 5 of 15 beyond the arc in the game. And Tavares Hardy simply wants his team to regroup. He can't have empty possessions when trying to erase a near 30-point deficit. The Tigers' lead is 53-28. A timeout here in Little John.
There's never been a better time to get away. With a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Hurry in to get our best deals of the season. Get in and get away. Get 0% APR on the 2023 Santa Fe. Plus zero payments for 90 days. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
Come on, cover girls. It's time to turn it up.
Exhibitionist Stretch and Strengthen Mascara. It's an instant lash extension effect.
The best mascara I have ever used.
Exhibitionist Mascara from CoverGirl.
Grandma!
Walgreens Find Rx coverage is here to make Medicare easy. Even easier than those dances your grandkids love doing with you.
Okay.
Start Medicare shopping today with Walgreens Find Rx coverage. Plus, find low-cost copays. It's not too late to talk Medicare. Walgreens is here. Walgreens.
Hurry to get Black Friday deals now at Target. This week, save on the hottest gifts to get ahead this holiday. Event ends Saturday. Get low prices and great deals so you can holiday your way. Only at Target.
Hey, my name is Chandler, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the little pieces of the peppermint that you get. It tastes like it's just the top of the line peppermint. For me, no milkshake is topping the peppermint chip milkshake.
Hi, my name is Madison, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is how it just makes me feel like a kid again. I love the cherry on top and the sweet peppermint bark flavor. It's definitely on my list of things that bring me joy around the holidays.
I'll remember that chapter of my life forever. We laughed. We cried. We protected that Progressive home and auto bundle day and night. We were all of us dazzling. Like knights sworn to protect our kingdom. We knew it wouldn't last forever, but that's what made it special.
I know we'll be back tomorrow, right?
Yeah, but it'll never be today again.
Just get on the bus, Lord.
The new DC News Now is here.
And if you're an early riser, you're going to really like us.
We're bringing you your late news a little earlier, 9 p.m. Not too early, not too late. It's just right.
With four locations in the DMV, we're covering more ground and telling more of your stories.
The news of the day from where you live, like where you really live.
We'll see you tonight at 9 for DC News Now.
Your new choice for news, DC News Now. Tonight at 9. Check your local listings at dcnewsnow.com.
This is actually an opening round game in the Emerald Coast Classic. Tigers know they will get Iowa next down in the Destin, Florida area on Friday. I would suppose they hope that the tip-off against Cal or TCU Saturday is after about 4 p.m. so they can catch a little bit of the football game before they head over to the arena.
Absolutely. A lot of Clemson basketball fans do, too.
So a couple of Big Ten teams upcoming. Another school from the Baltimore area will be here in Little John, and a team picked to win the Colonial, the Tigers of Towson.
Towson's a really talented, experienced team, coached by Pat Scarry. Does an outstanding job. Got a lot of guys coming back this year.
Jones couldn't hit the three. He's 2 of 6 on the night beyond the arc. Here's Hemingway from downtown.
Much needed three right there by Alex Hemingway. The Tigers just want to try to find some sort of a rhythm offensively, try to finish this thing well over the last 12 minutes.
He is the second Tiger in double figures. He now has 10. Actually, the third Tiger to join Hunter and Tyson. Tyson leads everybody with 14 points. And another turnover. R.J. Godfrey back on the floor with the inbound. Gave Clemson some energy, I thought, on both ends of the court in that opening half.
And I think if you ask Coach Brownell, that's exactly what he would talk about. He loves Godfrey's enthusiasm, his energy on the defensive end. The North Gwinnett High School native physically is ready to play right now at this level, trying to catch up a little bit defensively.
Knocked out of bounds by Marquise Redding. Dylan Hunter. Godfrey and now Shefflin and over to Beadle. Beadle's a guy, of course, redshirted a year ago. That'll be an offensive foul on Godfrey. But I think Josh Beadle is someone they want to see take a big step this season and become a more reliable player. He picks up his first personal foul.
And I think Josh Beadle does too. You know, we see this post-entry right there. It's a good pass by Josh Beadle. R.J. Godfrey just drops his shoulder a little bit. That's on the scout. Turns right there and leads to a charge and a turnover.
Marquise Redding will give it away to Perry. Perry has it knocked away, gets it back. Dangerous pass. Godfrey was there, so was Hemingway. Good job by Clemson defensively.
Great job by R.J. Godfrey in the gap right there. Got two deflections. It led to a turnover.
Hunter lobs. Godfrey got hung up inside, and that'll be a third on Redding.
And I think Coach Brownell right now, at this point in the game, he's got three freshmen on the floor. Can those guys bring some defensive energy? Can they get their hands on some basketballs? It's a great job right here by R.J. Godfrey. He runs the floor, uses his big, strong body to post up right there. Really good guy, good player, good family. Dad obviously played in the NFL for a long time. Has an athletic background for sure.
Hemingway looks low. Godfrey again works on the defender, this time Brown. Brown the rebound. Sophomore from La Plata, Maryland, David Brown.
And that's a strong, aggressive take by R.J. Godfrey. Coach Brownell will take that.
Jones quickly to Brown on the wing. Jones defended by Beadle. Tries to dump it inside. Good effort around the basket by the Greyhounds. Andrews cannot buy a bucket. Jalen Andrews coming off an 18-point ball game a couple of contests ago against Brown and their first win of the year.
But you've seen the three young guys for the Tigers come in and bring some defensive energy. It's led to some deflections. Their rotation has been a little bit better, which is what Coach Brownell is looking for right now.
Jones brings it back in the front court. Tigers still better than 50% on field goals. Spin move inside, and it will not go down for Redding. Really never got a good shot off.
Great job by Ian Shiflin of making sure he doesn't foul right there. Coach Hardy wanted to call, didn't get it.
Hemingway, another three. He is 3 for 3 beyond the arc. He has 13 points. It was last week that he got a career-high 18 against USC Upstate.
And so much of these last three games for Alex Hemingway have helped him get his confidence back. Again, we talked about he led the Tigers in scoring on the foreign trip. He's feeling confident again right now.
And once again, the frustration for Jones has it taken away. 6 feet, he was towered over by the Tiger defenders. Shefflin, Redding defends. Kick to the wrong place. Goes out of bounds, and Loyola gets it back. Greyhounds have built the lead out to 31. The Tigers building the lead to 31. Greyhounds 0 for their last 7. And it's the biggest lead of the night for the Clemson team.
And so Coach Brownell is going to get Chauncey Wiggins back in the game. He got 10 minutes on Friday night. Look for him to play a lot over these last 9 minutes, but you've got 4 freshmen on the floor right now for the Tigers.
I like seeing Wiggins and Godfrey on the court at the same time.
I do too. This is a lineup I really like because I think Chauncey Wiggins' future is as a small forward for the Tigers that can use his length on the perimeter.
Fowray's had a good scoring second half. Looking to feed it into him. Backing in on Shefflin. Lefty hook. Nice job.
And that's the second time that Fowray's been able to turn to that right shoulder, get that left-handed hook off, scored it at the rim.
New career high for Alonso Fowray, originally from Spain. 15 points in the game. He had 13 a couple of years ago against Navy. Nice save by Wiggins on the baseline. Godfrey, right past Fowray.
Great job by R.J. Godfrey. Able to show that he can dribble the basketball, makes that spin move to a finish. That's an outstanding job. He's been aggressive offensively in the second half.
Back to a 31-point Clemson lead. Kuzemka beating Fowray. Goes to work on Wiggins. Kuzemka from outside. Andrews tried to run it down, unable to. Take a timeout. We're seeing what R.J. Godfrey can bring as he grows in this Clemson program.
Great job by the North Gwinnett native. Downhill with his right hand. Great finish at the rim for the Tigers.
There's never been a better time to get away. With a great deal on the Hyundai you've always wanted. With America's best warranty and up to 3 years complimentary maintenance. It's your journey. Own every mile at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Hurry in to get our best deals of the season. Get in and get away. Get 0% APR on the 2023 Santa Fe. Plus 0 payments for 90 days. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
Walgreens Find Rx coverage is here to make Medicare easy. Even easier than those dances your grandkids love doing with you. Start Medicare shopping today with Walgreens Find Rx coverage. Plus, find low-cost copays. It's not too late to talk Medicare. Walgreens is here. Walgreens.
The new DC News Now is here.
And if you're an early riser, you're going to really like us.
We're bringing you your late news a little earlier, 9 p.m. Not too early, not too late. It's just right.
With four locations in the DMV, we're covering more ground and telling more of your stories.
The news of the day from where you live, like where you really live.
We'll see you tonight at 9 for DC News Now.
Your new choice for news, DC News Now. Tonight at 9. Check your local listings at dcnewsnow.com.
Will remain radioactive for years to come. Well, thank goodness, it's time for the good news of the week.
And boy, do we need it.
Well, this safe driver saved money with the Snapshot app from Progressive. How do you feel?
Good.
He's better than good. He got rewarded for driving safe and driving less.
Sorry, Barb, just to confirm, this is the feel-good news of the week?
This is what we found.
Yay, Snapshot.
So communication on the basketball court is such a huge thing. Ian Shiflin right here, he's going to reverse this pass and he starts pointing at his teammate RJ Godfrey. He's going to get him cleared out of this corner so that you have a naked side ball screen, meaning there's nobody behind him. Alex Hemenway, though, comes off this ball screen. The Greyhounds go underneath it. He stops and shoots it. But a great job by Ian Shiflin talking to his teammates on the court, directing guys, ultimately creating a shot for a teammate.
Another good night for Hemenway, who came in shooting 41% beyond the arc. Tigers, for a ninth time under Brad Brownell, holding a team under 15 points in the first half of play. We're in a half and trying to go 9-0 all time in that regard. Just 14 opening half points. And Clemson with 43, and there's a guy who just shows you how the length can play to his advantage when he's that open down low.
And another really good pass by Josh Beadle. We talked about the redshirt freshman trying to settle in and gain his confidence. He's made some really nice passes tonight. That's going to help him moving forward.
16 turnovers for the Greyhounds. Take another look at R.J. Godfrey, 6'7", 225.
R.J.'s a really strong, physical guy. His dad, Russell, played in the NFL for the Dallas Cowboys. He's a former Georgia Bulldog. But his son, RJ, is a terrific basketball player. Catches it right there at the rim, is able to use that lower body strength to get it up to the rim and finish.
Dylan Hunter, along with guys like Godfrey, who sets the screen, a freshman in this program. Beatles, a redshirt freshman. Got Wiggins top of your screen, and Middlebrooks, who just had it. Freshman and sophomore, respectively. Shot clock, under five, Beadle. Middlebrooks battling, and Perry couldn't save it.
So it's a really important 7 minutes right here, because even as you talk about Ben Middlebrooks, you're talking about a guy that came to college a year early. So you're talking about five freshmen, basically. And so just the ability to gain confidence and trust from Coach Brownell by playing well defensively and taking care of the basketball.
Wiggins looks low for Middlebrooks. Big on big, goes inside on Fowray, couldn't go underneath him. Fowray the rebound. He's having a good night. Told you a career high 15 points, now has 6 boards. Crossover Jones. Perry out high. Jones from the wing. Can't get his own rebound. Dylan Hunter, the quick hand. Yeah, you would suppose the guys who started this game, the veterans who played a bulk of the early minutes, are done for the night. Perry taking it away from Hunter from behind. Just how quick the point guard out of Baltimore is. He'll pull up for three.
Tough transition possession right there for Dylan Hunter. Comes down, falls, and Perry's able to take advantage of it and knock down that three. But again, you mentioned it, a big couple of minutes right here for these young Tigers to try to grow and develop.
And knocked away by Perry, who just hit his first three-pointer of the game. And then, good job coming from behind by Chauncey Wiggins. Clemson gets it right back.
I love Chauncey Wiggins' length on the defensive end. Runs the floor right there, gets that deflection from behind. It leads to a turnover.
And Wiggins inside.
Great interior passing there by the Tigers. The one thing Coach Brownell is going to tell them tomorrow when they watch film is they're starting to stand a little bit. He wants them to relocate. Hunter Tyson is one of the best at that. That's where he gets those open threes.
Fowray knocked away by Middlebrooks, and now the junior. Noted he had 15 points tonight. And that's his D1 best. He comes off an 18-point game against the Division III team, Washington from Maryland. And Fowrey picking up the personal. Looks like he's going to get a breather as he goes to the bench with his second foul.
But it's really good back-to-back games for Alonzo Fowrey. You know, played well in that game against Washington College, has played well here tonight. He'll be able to build on that as the Greyhounds head to Destin.
Hunter now working inside Godfrey. Really quick first step, went right up over Isaiah Alexander, 6'7".
Great ball fake to his right shoulder, set it up with the dribble, and then came back to the left shoulder in that right-handed jump hook. R.J. Godfrey's had a good second half tonight.
Jones, 6 points in the game. Redding giving it to his teammate Perry. Shot clock at 5. Perry. Alexander fade away on the baseline. And Beadle unable to corral the rebound. Fresh shot clock, quick shot. Perry hits another 3. Couple of trays for Deion Perry, who began 0-for-4 beyond the arc.
And Dylan Perry's got a bright future in front of him. The highly regarded freshman point guard out of Baltimore has continued to compete here in the second half. Got into a little bit better rhythm.
Hunter defended by Deion Perry. Gives up a few inches. Look at Dylan Hunter. That's why they expected him to come in and score so well right away, and he gets his own rebound. Godfrey out front.
RJ's had a really good second half. If he'd have knocked that down, he'd have really felt good about it.
Perry again from long range. Greyhounds 5 of 23 on three-pointers. Godfrey looking for Middlebrooks, double-teamed. Goes out of bounds. Take a timeout. Tigers rolling against Loyola here in Little John.
Make way for the first ever Chevy Silverado CR2. With Multimatic shocks, rugged 33-inch tires, and front and rear electronic locking differentials.
Dude, this is awesome, but we should get back to work.
It's good? Perfect.
If you're gonna work remote, work remote. Find new workspaces. Find new roads. Chevrolet.
Grandma!
Walgreens Find Rx coverage is here to make Medicare easy. Even easier than those dances your grandkids love doing with you. Start Medicare shopping today with Walgreens Find Rx coverage. Plus, find low-cost copays. It's not too late to talk Medicare. Walgreens is here. Walgreens.
Hi, my name is Jackie, and a little thing that I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the whipped cream and the cherry on top. It's like a little bow on top of this great present of peppermint chip goodness. The best way I can describe it to people is that it tastes like the holidays.
Hi, I'm Jordan. A little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A peppermint chip milkshake is the peppermint bark. It reminds me of peppermint bark that my grandmother used to make. It's the perfect crunch that sparks holiday joy. It's holiday-licious.
Hey, thanks for helping me out.
Of course. You can easily get helpful customer service over the phone or on the Progressive app pretty much anywhere, even at the library or the coffee shop. Get great customer support at the park or at this coffee shop.
Why would we go to a different coffee
mobile
shop?
Mobile order for Jay Money.
Thank you.
So is one of these places gonna be my car again or?
Right, even at your car.
Come
on, I saw you eyeing these scones earlier. Huh? Huh?
All right.
You get it.
Gosh, Santa Claus was here.
There's nothing better than being a kid on Christmas morning. Until you become a parent. And even though these moments don't last forever, Duracell can make them last longer.
Tigers freshman R.J. Godfrey getting extended minutes tonight, making the most of it.
Absolutely, and so much of it for R.J. Godfrey is his energy and his athleticism on the defensive end. You see that deflection, but he's also a really good rim finisher. You can see his lower body strength.
Drives it right there, pivots in the paint, good touch at the rim. R.J. Godfrey having a great night tonight, scoring at the rim and providing great energy on the defensive end.
His first 7 points in his Clemson career coming this evening. Did not play Friday night.
And so, Pete, I mentioned his dad, Randall, played at the University of Georgia. When I was at Georgia last year, we recruited him very hard, spent a lot of time with his family, great family out of North Gwinnett High School.
Beadle getting the bucket for the Tigers, 69-36. Clemson will hold an opponent under 50 yet again in Brad Brownell's tenure. Probably going to be tough to hold him under 40 because Perry heating up, three threes in the second half. But again, held the team under 15 points in a half with that very stingy defensive effort and allowing Loyola just 14 points in the opening 20 minutes and never letting the Greyhounds establish any rhythm offensively. Wiggins, he shows you some range.
And that's what he can do, Pete. 6'9", long, skilled, but can make that corner three. I think he's a guy that can help the Tigers down the road in ACC play.
Three-star prospect out of Grayson High in Georgia. Samuel Gibbs, one of their walk-ons on the court. They've got a very deep roster because so many players came back and so many scholarship guys came back. Perry, goes underneath as the shot clock was about to expire. Shefflin will come away with it.
Good defensive possession by the young Tigers on the floor right there. Coach Brennan will like that one in film tomorrow.
Shefflin looking low for Middlebrooks. Hunter, Shefflin. And a good job recovering defensively by Alexander. Here come the Greyhounds. Alexander goes inside on Middlebrooks, and he'll go to the line. Brad Brownell is going to empty his bench here momentarily.
So, Pete, when I was a walk-on for the Tigers, these were those moments kind of getting late in the game, 2 minutes, 1 minute. You know you're probably going to get in at some point. You're just trying to calm the nerves a little bit. Because so much for me when I got in the game, I didn't want it to look like you were out of place. You wanted to continue with an offensive flow. You knew everybody was going to yell shoot when you called it, but you're just trying to block that out.
Both Jack and Daniel Nassif coming in. Matt Kelly, Devin Foster. And look, these guys, they've got a really important role. You know, what fans don't see, obviously, is what goes on in practice. And it's incumbent on the walk-on players to make the scholarship guys better. And I know that was your charge when you were here at Clemson.
I felt like I grew my basketball IQ because we had to learn everybody else's offense. And then you had to go out and execute it in practice. And if you didn't do it correctly, you were going to hear about it. But, you know, head coach Larry Shiat, we took a lot of pride in that. His son, Jeremy, was a walk-on at the same time. We had a great time during those years.
Foster had a great high school career in Massachusetts, and Kelly unable to handle it. Here comes one of the walk-ons for Loyola. Gibbs gets it right back off the deflection to him by Brennan. Kind of crazy stuff there in Middlebrooks. Able to save it for the Tigers. Foster on the wing. Three on the way. Couldn't go down for Jack Nassif. And inside Daniel. Both Nassif's a chance.
One thing the Tigers guys off the bench have done, they've gone out there and gotten some shots up.
That they have. Under 30 to play. The rebound for Middlebrooks. Clemson probably just going to dribble it down, cross midcourt. And the Tigers will extend the winning streak to three and get win number four on the year, go to 4-1 on the season. And remain perfect at home. Loyola will fall to 2-3 as they begin their road swing through the upstate of South Carolina, then on down to Florida as they'll continue on in the Emerald Coast Classic. With the Tigers as well. 54-2 now when allowing under 50 points. And tonight the Tigers saw Loyola barely get past 40 points in a 72-41 victory.
Sure, so much of it for Coach Brownell and the staff is going to be what can they take away and get better at. There'll be some defensive clips in the first half that they'll want to teach and instruct from. There'll be some really good offensive clips in the first half that they can grow from as well.
Everybody who dressed for the Tigers got into the game. And look at that, a rejection for Jack Nassive. So a nice play for the big fella off the bench for a Clemson team that, save for a tight two-point loss, has gotten off to the very solid start their coach had hoped for with so many new faces on the roster this year. Now the Tigers get ready to take on what will be a very difficult Iowa team down in Florida. For Chase Hunter in Clemson, success on the night. It was another Hunter, Hunter Tyson, who led him in scoring with 14, one of three in double figures for the Clemson team. As always, JD, a lot of fun working alongside of you this evening.
Thank you, Pete. Great to be here.
Tigers get the win, their fourth of the year, 72-41. For J.D. Powell and our great crew, Pete Hannity saying so long from Little John. This has been a presentation of ESPN.
The winter sun,